In one of our videos, we have discussed incandescent and LED light bulbs and how they work. But to understand how light influences our life, we need to talk about lumens, light temperature, and colors. Therefore, we are going to jump into the electromagnetic spectrum, compare light bulbs, and understand why not to use flash when you take a photo of your food. There are two types of colors, spectral and received. While spectral colors are the ones in the visible light spectrum and their combinations, received color is what our brain receives from our eyes. It's also very easy to trick our brain to see things that are not really there. Let's see if I can trick your brain with this simple experiment. This is a negative photo. Stare into the white dot for a few seconds. Then, when the image changes, blink with your eyes for a few times. Have you noticed the change? The photo is in grayscale, but for some reason you saw its colors for a second. That is why when we have a combination of all colors from the sun, our brain translates it into white. By the way, from the solar radiation spectrum, we can see that our sun is more green than yellow, as we believe. Just like gray, white also has shades, but its shades are warm yellow, natural, or cold blue. The proper definition is correlated color temperature, or CCT, and it is measured in kelvins. When you are buying a new light bulb, you will see that one of the parameters is color temperature, which usually goes between 2500K to 6500K. So, I have a question for you. If kelvin is a unit to measure temperature, how come you can measure color with it? Does it mean that if you go to the shop and buy cold blue light bulb, it is going to emit 6000K? Well, if it did, you would probably evaporate in seconds because it's close to the sun's temperature. In order to understand it, we need to talk about blackbody radiation. If you have watched our video about IR thermometers, which you can find here, you should know that every matter above 0 Kelvin emits electromagnetic radiation. An ideal blackbody absorbs all radiation that falls into it. This also means it will emit at all frequencies depending on what thermal energy it receives. Let's have a look at this graph. As we can see, if a perfect blackbody is heated to a certain temperature, it has a peak at a specific wavelength, for example 6000K. The peak is the near the blue-white. What we did is to take those curves and compare them with the light that is emitted from our light bulb. As we can see, warmer colors are in the region of 2200K to 3000K, whereas colder colors start to appear from 4000K and above. You've probably noticed that when you go to a restaurant, the environment is cozy and there are more warm colors. But when you are in the kitchen or in the office or...
As you can see, those guys are having fun too!
Heavy metal music concert, the light setting is bluish. This is not just a coincidence, it's done on purpose. Just like the music you are enjoying right now in the background. It's on purpose. Warm sources are more flattering to red colors, clothes, and skin tones. On the other hand, cold sources are better to be used in working environment due to higher contrast. In general, it depends on what kind of environment you're trying to create. The best way to do so is simply to install lights and check if it fits your needs, but there are some suggestions. There are many guides out there for choosing the proper color temperature, but for the sake of understanding CCT, it should be enough. However, if you still got some questions, just ask, send an email, a video, a pigeon, just comment, and I will try to answer as quickly as possible. I've got a good tip for you. If you are one of those people who are taking pictures of their food, don't try to use the flashlight, especially if you are taking pictures of meat, because meat has got a lot of rats inside and the flashlight is going to kill all of them, so your food is going to look pale. Talking about sick colors, another important feature of your light source is to accurately recreate the colors it illuminates on the object. So, in other words, this is called Color Rendering Index, or CRI. CRI is calculated based on how well the light source renders 8 specific pastel colors, compared with natural or ideal one that goes from 0 to 100. An example of a light source with a good CRI is an incandescent light bulb which has CRI above 95. On the other hand, Cool white fluorescent lamps have a CRI of about 60. While a proper CRI test is very hard to conduct without some sophisticated equipment, we can still show the differences between a light source with poor CRI and a good one. We have three different light sources with the same CCT, and our test subjects today are those yummy, yummy fruit. Can you spot the differences? I like when everything makes sense. So far we've covered CCT, CRI, and here 13 watts equals 75. What? I hope the person who wrote this was not an accountant. Okay, calm down, it's not an error. Watt is the unit for measuring power. More watts means that the light source consumes more power and you pay more. With the incandescent light bulbs, more watts means also more light output. It doesn't work with LED lamps. One manufacturer can have an LED that uses 10 watts and produces 470 lumens, while another manufacturer produces an LED with the same power consumption but emits 550 lumens. Therefore, we are measuring the brightness of the light source with lumens. To put it simply, lumen is a measurement unit for how bright the light source is. More lumens, more light, right? Not always. If we compare two LEDs, non-directional and directional, with the same lumen specs, we can see the directional looks brighter. The light from the non-directional LED is emitted in all directions and lights up areas that we not necessarily need. That is why you should always check the useful lumen rating, which is the emitted light in a standardized 90-degree cone. It is lower than the total amount of lumens that the LED can emit, but it's more relevant. If you wish to have the same bright light with an LED as your 75-watt incandescent light bulb, for example, you can try an LED with 1100 lumens. By the way, I've got another joke. What did one traffic light say to another? Stop looking, I'm changing. Hilarious, right? Yeah. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you want more, go to our channel right here. How many times did you have to change? Stop looking, I'm changing. Like it or not, make sure you subscribe. The next are coming. If you need more information, read the description below and have fun.